town is a man responsible for writing the perfect screenplay, Chinatown. He's one of the best writers in the business, but his roots, like most writers in Hollywood, are humble. For his first few jobs in film, he worked as an assistant director on a few B-movies for Roger Corman, where he would make many new friends with people who, like himself, became powerful in the world of film. Because of Towne's growing connections in the business, he worked as a script doctor for many famous and groundbreaking Hollywood screenplays. He helped his friend Warren Beatty, bolstering the overwrought script of 1967's Bonnie and Clyde, by editing dialogue, rearranging the second half of the movie, and writing a few crucial scenes. Francis Ford Coppola called on Towne to write a scene that resolved the relationship between Vito Corleone and Michael in 1972's groundbreaking film The Godfather, the famous garden scene, where the elderly Don passes the leadership of his family to his youngest son. Towne's work on The Godfather introduced the writer to Robert Evans, who would produce Towne's masterpiece, Chinatown. Towne cemented his status as a sought-after screenwriter in Hollywood by writing 1974's The Last Detail, an adaptation of the best-selling novel. This paired Towne with two of his friends, producer Robert Evans and actor Jack Nicholson. However, the trio would later leave their true mark on Hollywood through another collaboration, a movie released that same year. Towne drafted the script for Chinatown, his first original screenplay, with Nicholson in mind for the lead during the production of The Last Detail. Towne worried about the film's potential success because of considerable drama on the set between him and director Roman Polanski, who demanded constant rewrites and grew angry with the writer who, admittedly, tended to procrastinate. The risk did pay off, however, in spite of the drama. A few months after the film was released, Towne won Chinatown's only Oscar of the 11 for which the film was nominated for Best Original Screenplay. Towne graced the red carpet again in the next year, nominated for Shampoo, his collaboration with the actor-producer who hired him to fix the script of Bonnie and Clyde, Warren Beatty. Towne attempted to gain auteur status by writing and directing 1982's Personal Best, starring Muriel Hemingway. And to complete the project as director, Towne sold the rights to the screenplay of a film called Greystoke, a Tarzan's origin movie released in 1984. Towne's vision for the film did not align with the vision of director Hugh Hudson, who edited the screenplay beyond recognition. Towne regretted selling the script, so much so that he credited his dog with writing the Tarzan flop. P.H. Vazek became the first dog nominated for an Academy Award. After those failures, the frustrated writer would attempt to doctor his career through another collaboration with Evans and Nicholson. The three friends wanted to replicate their success 11 years after Chinatown, the sequel to The Neo-Noir, the two Jakes who failed miserably. By then, Nicholson and Evans had become stars in their own respective fields, and their egos had grown too large to fit the same film. Towne played a direct disagreement with Nicholson about the casting of Evans in an important role because the producer simply could not act. Tensions rose to the point where Nicholson pulled the celebrity card saying, "I'm the movie star, Bob," and Towne left the production with an unfinished script to vacation in the Bahamas, unreachable by phone, leaving Nicholson alone to direct. After this falling out, Towne would move to independent projects where he had more artistic freedom, writing and directing without limits, and Ask the Dusk. His most recent success comes from the blockbuster movie franchise Mission Impossible, for which he wrote the first two movies. Although Towne has produced little work since 2000 when Mission Impossible 2 hit theaters, he currently works on a remake of Hitchcock's The 39 Steps. Despite his faltering later career, his reputation as a brilliant screenwriter remains intact. As Hollywood screenwriter Billy Ray said of his work, "None of us